In this session, I'm going to talk about journal entries. There are a couple ways you can do journal entries within Business Central. They're very simplistic to do, and I'll walk you through both of them. So once you log into Business Central, you're going to see your finance menu. I'm going to click on finance and then general journals. It's going to open up a batch list. In this case, out of the box, you always have like all journals, a standardized default batch. Batches are for segregating your journal entries. So the perfect example is at month end, if you have two or three accountants doing journal entries, you could segregate and keep everybody in within their own batch of entries, because if everybody uses one batch at the same time, then you're going to be stepping on each other's toes. There's going to be entries that just appear out of nowhere. There's potential that somebody could delete your entry and so forth. So you want to keep everybody separate by having their own batch. And by doing that, I could just quickly, since I'm in the batch list, click on new, and then I'm just going to simply call it my batch. And I'll just give it a description. Not needed, but I will just do that. And I will close out. And I see now I have my batch. I'm going to click into that, and this opens up journal for my journal entries. Posting date, you're going to see throughout the whole system where this is your impact to GL. So every time you see posting date, it's a mandatory field. You are obligated to populate it because of the fact that it does impact your trial balance. So it always will default to your work date, or you could put in any date that you like. So if let's go 0320. Document type is typically not used on journal entries. This is if you want to segregate and classify your entry, whether it's a payment, invoice, credit memo, etc. But for journal entry purposes, not needed. Document number automatically populates based on a particular setup within number series. We could have that overwritten if you want to, or we could not have it auto-populate. That's just a quick setting that we could control. Account type is always going to be GL account. You could, as you see, you could create journal entries to your customer, vendor, bank account, fixed assets, etc., all the way down. And this would actually create subledgers to the customer or vendor or bank, as well as hit the GL at the same time. So it's not only direct GL entries you're potentially creating, but you could also create subledger entries as well. So I'll just stick with the standardized GL entries, and I'm going to just choose any account. So let's go, let's just say I'm going to do, salary expense. Obviously, as you see, the name automatically populates. I could put in a description if I wanted to. As you see, it's the same as the account name, and this is open for you to edit to your liking of a further description. Not needed, but you can. You could, if you're working with currency codes, you could decide what currency this transaction is in. And of course, the dollar amount, which is going to be a positive is a debit, negative is a credit. And I'm just going to be simplistic here, and I'm just going to put $2,500. If I want to tag it to a department code, which is a dimension code, and if you're not familiar with dimensions, you could see it in prior recordings I have. But you could also tag it within a dimension code, i.e., which in this case is department. And I'll just say it's going to go to my sales department. So that's my debit side. And then I'm going to just go down a line. You see some of the information automatically defaults down. It's not an established line yet because I have a zero here. I got blank here. But it does default some standardized information because you want to keep it in balance. And the system always wants you to keep a journal entry in balance by posting date, document number, and amount, right? So let's go into, and I'm just going to say 1500, and I will offset this to, I'll just say I'm going to cut it to my checking account. And then I'm going to decrease it. Again, negative, which is going to be my credit account. Now, I may not need a department code for this. I may be okay because it's a cash account. Maybe I'm not tracking department codes by my cash account. So I will leave that blank. If I want to put one in here, I could, but because I won't be reporting in my cache by department, I could leave that blank. Now, all I have to do at this point, and I could continually go forward and create as many entries as I want, one after the other, after the other, after that. So I just continue to go down. So as you see, my total balance down here is zero, which is great. That's what I want. Because remember, this journal will not post unless the journal is balanced. And again, that's balanced by posting date, document number, and amount. So if I go down into the next line, you'll see what the system did. It automatically gave me the next number. Because I was in balance with this journal entry, the system gave me the next journal entry number. Now, of course, if I wanted to, and I want to have the whole batch into one journal entry number, I could override that or hit F8, which is your function key that copies above, and it could be one. Or I could have each balanced journal entry its own unique journal entry. So I could go on and on. There's unlimited amount of journal entries that it will take. So don't think you're limited to, I can only do, what's my max? Okay, I can only do 10, can I only do 20? No, you get as many journal entries as you want within one batch. Okay. So I'm going to go back up here, say, yep, I'm happy there. And what I can also do is hit this preview posting. This preview posting tells you if there's any errors. Okay, that it doesn't like. So if I was to post, did you do an actual posting, this will tell you any errors it doesn't like. So this tells me error, and it's in red, when I'm it's looking that because I didn't do a default description in here, because again, there's another setting in the system where you could say, yeah, I want to have a default description, or I always want to use a description. That way it doesn't go in with a blank description. And that's just a setting. So I'm just going to type in paid bonus. Okay. And now let's try it again. Post print, preview posting. Great. That means you see there's no errors, which is great. That's one thing I wanted to see. But what you could also see is number of entries. It's showing you if I was to post this, it's going to create two entries. And I could click on the number two here. And it's going to show you, okay, your impact's going to be on 330 to GL number 60700, a positive 2500, and to 10100 and credit of 2500. Now, of course, this is very simplistic, but just imagine if you had a long amount of entries, how helpful this would be. So this gives you kind of a validation before you actually truly post transactions. Because once they're posted, it's not like you could simply delete it. You could reverse entries, but there's multiple steps behind it. So it's always good to validate before you actually post. If I'm good with that, then I'm going to go back into posting, and I can either post, which would post a journal, or post and print, which again will post a journal and print out a register. So that's up to you. I'm just going to go to post. Successful. And they disappear. Now, there's another way of doing this as well, and I'm going to do the same exact journal entry, but slightly different. So I'm going to go back to salary, and I'm going to do 1500, and I'm going to do sales. Now, the difference, what if you remember what I did, is I dropped to a second line and created the offset. Now, if I know this is going to be I only have one line offset, basically a one for one. So if my salary expense, I'm not going to allocate it across the, down the line to two or three other accounts. So basically, I just need an offset. Well, what is over here, if I slide over to the right, there's a balance account type. So again, I could, change this to be a customer vendor. So I could have my GL one side to go to a GL expense, and then I want to balance it off to either another GL account or maybe my customer, vendor, or bank account. Okay, so if I want to do bank account, this is almost doing the same thing, and my checking account, or I could go back to my GL account and checking account, right? Either or. And now, instead of having two line entries, my total balance down here is also zero because what I did is my initial entry of my salary expense for $1,500, I told the system for sales, because I want a department in there, I'm going to balance it off to this GL number here. And now I'm all set. So when I go to post this, it's going to actually do the debit of $1,500 to salaries expense and automatically balance it off to GL number 10100. So let's take a look. I'm going to go to preview posting. And I got no errors, which is great. And it's still hitting the same accounts as I did in the first entry. So instead of doing a two-line entry, I did it all in one line by leveraging the balance account type and number. And then, of course, the last step would be to post. And we're done. That's how simple journal entries are within Business Central. Thanks for watching. If we could further assist you, please reach out to us here at epcgroup.net.